Okay. Tonight I'm going to talk about navigating i18n in C with Gatsby. So there are two acronyms here. Anybody is familiar with i18n? What is this? Okay, so less than half. So i18n here is a numeronym which stands for internationalization. It's an effort. So if you have the book, the stripes, increment magazine, just read the whole book. That's i18n. And C here means Southeast Asia, because I'm going to talk about the Japan website, which is serving countries across Southeast Asia. Here is my Twitter handle, and it's my personal website. So I'm Zen Potami. I am an Indonesian. I live here in Singapore with my wife and two kids, and then I'm working at Ninja Fam Singapore for the past 2 years. Previously, I was a back-end developer. I just turned in the front-end developer recently when I worked in Ninja Fam. And I also co-organized React.js Indonesia meetups from Singapore. So I mostly organize the online meetups one. But I also attended one of the offline meetup. So this talk will be about my personal journey in developing Ninja Fam website, and I will also talk about how to configure Gatsby to serve an internationalized website, and I will talk a little bit about handling automatic redirection for website with multiple domains. And I'm not going to talk about setting up the internationalization library or the localization platform. So technically, we're using this, like Intel and localized in Ninja Fam, but I'm not going to talk about it because of the time constraint. Okay, let's start with the problems. We in Ninja Fam serve 6 countries: Indonesia, Malaysia, Thailand, Philippines, Vietnam, and Singapore. Some of them have low English literacy, so we have to provide the website with in local languages. But then Google needs different URLs for different languages for the sake of search engine optimization. Because if we serve a single page with one URL but with two content, with different languages, then Google will be confused. Will be confused when it is tracking our website, so we won't get our website optimized for search engine. So the first aspect of the solution is, since we are using Gatsby, why don't we pick a relevant starter? So we decided to pick this starter. At that time, this is, I think, the best starter. But after I check and Gatsby starter, other starter options, there are some new starters which probably much more comprehensive than this one. But then, that starter doesn't differentiate URLs on different languages, so it doesn't solve our third problem, which we have to serve in different URLs. So we just pick an officially recommended plugin for that. So in the official page, they recommended this. And then, the implementation of that plugin is pretty simple. We just name our files with an additional extension before the JS extension, and then that additional extension will be transformed into as a part of the URL. So for example, if we name our file with about the NGS, it will be transformed into a page with this URL. So oops. looks simple, right? Then let's do it. So here, let's try to implement the home page. In the home page, we have the index.js file, and then this will eventually becomes the home page and the website. Since we have to serve 6 countries, then we have to serve this path, right? So we added 6 more files. But those are actually only for English. So for local languages, we need to add 3 more files. For Indonesia, Thailand, and Vietnamese. That will makes us having 10 files in total just for one single page. So those 10 files are only for one page, which is the home page. And we have at least 14 pages in our website. So this could blow to 140 files at least. And among those files, and 90% of those files are simply like just like this. Since, yeah, so we just import whatever implemented in the default page and then simply re-export it. That's it. Because in our case, we don't need to render the page differently. All the conditional rendering, all the transitions are handled through React Intel. There must be another way for this. So, yeah, luckily we are in the open source world, so we can traverse all the source code that we are using. So I tried reverse engineering the plugin, which looks like this. So just like what Lihao explained before, this plugin, apparently they uses a lot of Gatsby node. So if you open this file, yeah, this Gatsby node.js file is actually using these 3 APIs, and these APIs are implemented within different files. So after traversing a lot of what's happening in the plugin, apparently we found out that we only needed a small part of it. So let's try implement that small part from scratch instead of using the plugin. And we're going to use only this API, the onCreatePage API. So here is our Gatsby-node.js file. Here we are exporting this function, which will eventually be called by Gatsby in build time. This function receives page and action properties, and then we import list of locales we serve, which contains all these 9 locales that we are exporting. And we simply look on the locales. Here I have a skip logic to skip some pages, but for now let's hard code it into false value. So for each locale, we gonna do clone the page object. So from the page object here, we just clone using object assign. And then we replace the locale, we replace the first segment of the URL with the locale that we are currently iterating. And then we call the create page action to create the new page that we just modified. So this will return a new page object, which is different than the first one. And since we don't want to do it for all pages, we skip for some pages which is unnecessary to do. So like the 404 page, it's supposed to be in Gatsby, it's supposed to be so our Engine X or anything that serves the static sites, it's supposed to be redirecting to the 404 page, and we don't need it to be translated in we don't need to to be differentiated between languages, so we just use that one page for our page. So we don't do the same. We don't do this thing for the page. Yeah, that's it. So we only need about 14 lines, I think, to implement that feature. Then let's compare the build performance. In the old implementation, where we are using Gatsby plugin i18n, with only two pages localized, that means 18 JavaScript files executed for nothing. The simple files which only importing and exporting the page object. It resulted in 163 seconds for building 39 HTML pages. Imagine we have 14 pages, so it can increases a lot significantly. But with the new implementation, which is using on-create page node API and no re-executing JavaScript files because we are simply copying the created page objects, we can have this performance, which is around 78 seconds for building 138 HTML pages. So from that lesson, we learned that it doesn't mean that the plugin is bad. It's still pretty useful for some use cases. For example, using different layouts for each languages or for blogs where people, we can see some of our fellow developers having an internationalized blog. Even they open source the translation efforts, and it's possible because of this kind of plugin where we have different files for different translations. So the lesson is, do not take any Gatsby plugins for granted. Evaluate build and runtime performance continuously, because probably we can implement the features from scratch. I add a bonus for this. So earlier I mentioned that we serve in two different domains. NinjaExpress.co is only for Indonesia country, because in Indonesia it's uncommon to use fan for delivering parcels. So if we are using Ninja Fan brand, then it's irrelevant because usually you use motorcycle to deliver parcels. But then for the rest of the countries, we still use NinjaFan.co. So we are not serving those in different servers, but instead we point both domains into the same server. But then we will have the problem with what if people in Singapore accessing this website? Or vice versa, what if people in Indonesia accessing this website? So we do a simple JS redirection for path and domain mismatch. So for example, if somebody is visiting, well, the error is not there, so let's here we are accessing ninjafan.co but in Indonesia, and it will automatically redirect to Ninja Express. It's just done using simple JavaScript. But then what if the user disables JavaScript, or what if the crawlers, the search engine like Google, crawls our website? We also set up the href lang tag for SEO. So it is tag for, yeah, so roughly there is an illustration like this. So the same page with different language, they can reference each other and tell the search engine that this is also served in other languages in this URL, and vice versa. Okay, that's all. Thank you, Jamstack, the technology build, and Stripe for providing.